But the problem is that my goal here, rather than maybe established, not solid, wrapped up the peace of the children and their education. We pray, Father, for those who protect and serve, again, that you would bless them. Father, as we look forward to a new year, we pray that you would reflect the vision for this community, that you would keep us ever diligent of the needs of the people. Keep us ever mindful that we are the servants, serving one another to bless our lives. Thank you, in Jesus' name.
Is that it?
We have five bidders, Gunn Jeter, Mr. Lewis, Dr.
systems off, and you get button corporation. You get button corporation, one's a little better, $656,500. And I trade back to 15 with roofing. We have four bidders, Lynch Roofing, E.C. Babilla, Madison Sun, and Corellis Roofing. E.C. Babilla was a little better, $426,543. Aluminum wall panels, we had two bidders, E.C. Babilla and Corellis Roofing. Corellis was a little better, $293,247. Great back to 70, aluminum curtain wall, and storefronts. We had three bidders, Lozaro, Meyer Glass, from Trial Glass and Mirror. Trial Glass and Mirror was a little bidder, $463,453. Paintings and wall coverings, we had three bidders, Stennis, Lutheran and Sun Painting, and Altec. Lutheran and Sun was a little bidder, $242,690. Flooring, we had one bidder for flooring, TSI Commercial Flooring, $187,160. That's the package 19, and package 20 was for the Atlantic Flooring. T3 USA was the only bidder we had for that package, $355,990. And package 21 was the rock climbing wall. We had Eldorado climbing walls, and then we had another company, Enterprise. Eldorado was a little bidder, $242,914. Great package 22, fire suppression system. We had three bidders. We had State Line, we had Valley Fire Protection, and we had Central States Automatic Sprinklers. Valley Fire Protection was a little bidder, $141,910. HVAC, we had three bidders, Amber Mechanical Concepts, Circle R Mechanical. Circle R was a little bidder, $759,900. Plumbing, we had one. We had six bidders. We had Mechanical Concepts, LGS, V&L Plumbing, Circle R, Redtail Plumbing, and Keel Mechanical. V&L was that little bidder, $330,000.
What was LGS?
LGS was $369,387. Electrical, we had three bidders, MCOR Hire, Midwestern, and also Sweeney Electric. Sweeney was a little bidder, $1,269,700. Three packages 26 was for athletic equipment. We had three bidders, Lee Company, Toadline, and then SportsCon. Lee Company was our low bidder, $194,970. Thank you. town engineer administrator endorsed in core construction recommendation and only contract that was set, right?
Yes, I'm covered that, yes.
Attention to top paper register module approval for December 25th and amendments from the secret test.
So moved. Second.
Motion by Councilman Cabbage, second by Councilman Merrill, that we approve the Senate initial instruction. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries seven zero. Standing committee, budget and finance, Councilwoman Bear.
No report.
Only vote, Councilman Minchuk. Councilman Bennett, Councilwoman Lamarcus.
Aye.
Personal policy employee benefits, Councilman Bennett.
No report.
Public safety, Councilwoman Newsflag.
Nothing, Mr. Chairman.
Parks and Recreation, Councilwoman Lamarcus.
I have nothing, but can I hear something?
No report, Mr. Chairman.
No report, no.
Environmental affairs, Councilwoman Bear.
No report.
Elections and public relations, Councilwoman Newsflag.
No report.
Economic development, Councilman Bennett.
No report.
Utility labor, Councilman Span.
No report.
Abandoned properties, no report. That concludes standing committee. General order, ordinance 19-31, an ordinance of town of Merrillville, County, Indiana, providing that the zoning ordinance, town of Merrillville, County, Indiana, be amended by changing the established R5 medium density multi-family residential district to a PUD, home unit development classification. Motion to approve ordinance 19-31, please. Motion by Councilman Minchuk, second by Councilman Bennett, to approve ordinance 19-31, any discussion? Roll call, please.
Chair.
Yes.
Minchuk.
Yes.
Newsflag.
Yes.
Bear.
Yes.
Bennett.
Yes.
Lamarcus.
Yes.
Yes. Mr. President, Mr. Minchuk, you want to suspend the rules, yeah?
Yeah.
I'll move to the following, suspend the rules, proceed to a second reading, pending any people of public comment. Second, motion by Councilman Minchuk, second by Councilman Bennett, to suspend the rules for ordinance 19-31, any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. Second reading ordinance is, ordinance 19-28, an ordinance of the town of Merrillville, County, Indiana, amending 1926, and specific part of the town of Merrillville, Indiana, for the calendar year 2020. Motion by Councilwoman Bear, second by Senator Markey.
Yes.
Second by Councilwoman Newsflag, that we approve on second reading ordinance 19-28, any discussion? Because this is a second reading ordinance, would you like to open a public comment on ordinance 19-28? Any public comment on ordinance 19-28? Any public comment on ordinance 19-28? Roll call.
Chair. Minchuk.
Yes.
Newsflag.
Yes.
Lamarcus.
Yes.
Bennett.
Yes.
Lamarcus.
Yes.
And Harvey.
Yes. Motion carries. What is this? Ordinance 19-29, an ordinance of the town of Merrillville, Lake County, Indiana, fixing department reverting program fees for the year 2020, establishing fees for 2020 park department program.
Second.
Motion by Councilwoman Bear, second by Councilwoman Newsflag, that we approve ordinance 19-29, any discussion? Because this is a second reading ordinance, we'd like to open up for public comment. Any public comment on ordinance 19-29? Any public comment on 19-29? Any public comment? Roll call.
No. Minchuk.
Yes.
Newsflag.
No.
Bear.
Yes.
Bennett.
Yes.
Lamarcus.
Yes.
Harvey.
Yes. Motion carries 6-1. Ordinance 19-31, an ordinance of the town of Merrillville, County, Indiana, providing that the zoning ordinance, town of Merrillville, County, Indiana, be amended by changing the established R5 medium density multi-family residential district to a PUD, land unit development classification.
Motion.
Motion by Councilman.
Yes, Minchuk.
Councilman Minchuk, second by Councilwoman Newsflag and Councilwoman Bear. Is there any discussion? Because this is the second reading ordinance, I don't have a public public comment on ordinance 19-31. Any public comment? I can't hear you, sir. You have to come up and state your name and your address, please. Come first. From the law firm of Cornelius Duval and Peracki. I'm here on behalf of the petitioner, and I was here at the last Upside Commission meeting. Many of you are familiar with this project. For those of you that are not familiar with the project, I'm just going to brief introduction. What we're planning on doing is providing assisted living facilities for adults with disabilities. The individuals that would be targeted for this assisted living facility would be over the age of 18 and dealing with autism, ADHD, and other mental disabilities. The goal is to provide assistance to those with mental disabilities so that they can live their life to the fullest in a dignified manner within the context of family-dependent housing that will give them some freedom while also providing 24-hour assistance. In addition to the housing projected to include 18 buildings with 141 units, the plan calls for an administrative office and operations building that would also be the new home of the adult daycare program, which is currently operated by the petitioner Tumby Revolving Home Services on Broadway. They're currently located at the corner of Broadway 54th. For those of you familiar with my client's operations, which is across the street from the plaza that operates the Family Dollar and Save Lot Plaza. I have with me the petitioner and our engineer, Jack Alton, from DVG. If there are any specific questions, I'd like to see you at the last meeting, we did obtain unanimous approval from the Planning Commission, and we are hopeful to obtain a favorable vote at tonight's meeting. If anybody would have any comments or questions, I'd be happy to address them at this time. I know Councilman Mitchell has been very helpful. And I know others also on the other Planning Commission were very favorable. But for those that were at the last meeting or were not, that remains, I'd be happy to address any comments or questions at this time.
Okay. I think everything was in order.
Right, John?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Yes.
We're Stephen Jackson, initially on the property, 545 East West 30th, developing top of our area. And I'm built on the top of our area.
We can allow the developer fully understands how our work drivers and is confident no one associated with the developer will have any issues or complaints. The plans for this development cast that are fluctuating. What we thought going into the meeting was that what was presented at the 12-17-19 meeting, the request from phases changed to carte blanche and everything was approved. Part of this was off going and the approval was granted. Why the request? Extremely revealing and very interesting concern. After giving approval, the board council will get a hub. We are owners of a decades-old business and are tax-paying property owners in Merrillville. It's extremely disconcerting that our council didn't feel it necessary to take the time to address our concerns or to reassure us for the delays of protection of foreign parties. No bumpkins. It's only a law that people are let you talk. Developers come and go, leaving lowly taxpaying property owners contending with the repercussions of voter cash under the guise of so called progress. It's my opinion that Earth is being pillaged by developers and officials taking progress is making money from covering up open natural structures. True progress could be utilized in increasing the number of abandoned structures on already violated land. We continue to decimate the ecosystem and habitats on natural open lands. But they are natural defense is necessary to combat the evils of climate change. Once the valuable commodities are obliterated, so do human global farms and individuals which provide the food necessary for our very existence. Oh well, now we can go on waiting to see how long before our borders and fences are encroached upon by new species, or police are called to stop our activities, or we have to contend with a lawsuit, or when we slowly get added to the list of numerous businesses that Merrillville once had.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
this to the public comments. Town hall will be closed December 24th and 25th and December 31st and January 1st. Planning commission meeting is just a workshop. That's what I was going to ask you to do. We don't have any items. President's going to cancel the workshop because, Mr. President, we have the inauguration, depending on the officers, and appointments to be made. They wouldn't be caught up, and we don't know. Who's going to be on the line next?
Okay.
So I'll go ahead and cancel that workshop here on the 7th, and then subsequently the 21st.
The 21st will be the next meeting.
Next town council meeting is January 14th at 6:30 p.m. Now.
Thank you.